Hey Lupus Life Hackers, Janine here from Lupus Health Shop. Welcome back to my channel, the number one spot for lupus warriors who want to learn more on how to decrease symptoms naturally through a functional medicine approach. Subscribe and click on that bell if you haven't already, because we are the number one spot for the holistic approach on lupus. All right, so this week's topic, what does anti-inflammatory mean? What are antioxidants? It's important to know so that you steer clear of the wrong ones and include the right ones in your diet. All of these words sound so cool, they sound exciting, definitely are, but we need to know exactly what they're doing in our food and our supplements, and what are they talking about? So anti-inflammatories are substances that reduce inflammation. They may block inflammatory pathways or stimulate cells that reduce inflammation in your body. You're probably more familiar with something like NSAIDs, right? That's usually what we would take for any flare-ups. Like, for example, ibuprofen or aspirin. Many foods and spices actually have these occurring naturally as well, like turmeric. The only issue is that those types of anti-inflammatories are not addressing the underlying problem because they're just tackling symptoms. Whereas food and spices and herbs, those are digging deeper and they include more properties that will help you heal and prevent symptoms of inflammation. Because if we have inflammation in our body, that's what causes the pain. Antioxidants are compounds that are in foods and herbs like vitamins, minerals, there's flavonoids, and so much more. They're substances that reduce cellular damage by binding to and inactivate reactive oxygen molecules. Have you heard of the term free radicals? Make sure to tap the thumbs up if you learned something new so far. You know when you cut open an apple or avocado or bananas and it starts to turn brown? Well, that's oxidation occurring in fruit. It's kind of like the same concept in our body. Our cells are exposed to free radicals that can produce oxidative stress. When they contain reactive oxygen species, they're super unstable in the body. And if it's unstable, it can cause a lot of damage to our cells. It can cause damage to our proteins and DNA. If it's causing damage to our cells, that means our cells cannot perform the function they're supposed to. And that's where chronic issue comes in. Oxidants are free radicals in the body and in the environment. So our body actually creates them to fight viruses and microbes. Your immune system uses these free radicals to fight infections. So if you have too many, that's the problem. It's important for your body to maintain a balance of free radicals and antioxidants. Also, if your body isn't working properly, which if you have an autoimmune disease or a chronic condition, it's not. Control and prevent anything without functional medicine intervention. If you're not sure what functional medicine is, make sure to subscribe because I will be doing a video on this in 2 weeks. When we talk about pro-inflammatory, there are many pro-inflammatory foods, and unfortunately, these include processed meats, sodas, salty snacks, any packaged items, and refined carbohydrates. Even worse, that's stuff that's more affordable. However, I do have a video on affordable, healthy foods. I've actually cut my grocery bill in almost half, and that's because I shop fruits and vegetables and stay away from processed foods. That stuff does add up, but when you stick with the healthy stuff on the outskirts of this grocery store, and you stick with what's in season, it's cheaper.
Like what you see so far, subscribe and click on the bell so you don't miss out next week on our new video. Now back to the topic of the week.
So if you suffer from autoimmune diseases like lupus, these types of foods that are processed or that are pro-inflammatory make our symptoms way worse. And that's because our body's not working the way it's supposed to. So it's too busy fighting so many things that it continues to fight so many things. And so we're exhausted. We have migraines, brain fog, stomach problems, and the list goes on. What pro-inflammatory means is what you're ingesting is likely to cause inflammation in the body, especially in those with autoimmune issues. But symptoms vary, like I said. So for sure though, we're all experiencing inflammation, whether we can see it or not. Certain foods, particularly gluten and dairy, lead to leaky gut, which is a necessary precursor to autoimmune and leads to even more inflammation in our body. What leaky gut is, it's when there are too many gaps in your lining of your gut, and that's where toxins and particles are flying out into your body. And that is why we react to so many different things all the time. When we're eating or if we're out, we become very sensitive. Fortunately, by removing those toxins and inflammatory foods from your diet and replacing them with nourishing foods that support your health, you can reduce inflammation. and work your way back down the autoimmune spectrum. Tap the like button if you've learned something new. Subscribe if you want to learn more. Now that you know what anti-inflammatories and antioxidants are from a scientific level, next week I'm going to go into more detail on how each affect lupus. In the meantime, while you wait for that awesome video to come out, check out these two videos over here to learn more about decreasing symptoms of lupus naturally. Thumbs if you loved it, thumbs if you liked it. I appreciate your support, and I can't wait to see you next week.